BMW's mid-engine supercar started as a Skunk Works project. BMW took the suspension bits from the E9 to BMW M3 with the competition package and essentially bolted them into the 1 Series. This experiment resulted in the ultimate BMW. We fell hard for its smooth and torque-rich turbocharged 6, balanced handling, refinement, chassis rigidity, steering clarity, and adorably aggressive looks. It was like a greatest hits album, and then BMW took it away, discontinuing the car after a short, sweet 1-year run. Today's 1 Series M. The new M2 is the exact same formula as the 1 Series M, but done with newer BMW components. There's a lot of F82 BMW M4 under the skin of the new M2. Most of the aluminum suspension components, the limited slip differential, the brakes, and the forged 19-inch wheels are pulled from the M4. Of course, these parts don't quite fit into a regular 2 Series. So, the M2 has big, bulging front and rear fenders that effectively communicate that the car would very much like you the hell out of its way. Like the M4S, the M2S setup is very stiff, and it'll jiggle your flabby bits. Unlike the M4, you can't get electronically adjustable dampers to soften the blow. The M2 has its own conventional shocks and springs tuned specifically for that car. While the ride shakes us, there's not so much as a quiver from the structure. A plate added to the front end cinches the already tight 2 Series structure even tighter. In the canyons, the M2 has the same grip and feel as an M4. The tires aren't as wide as its big brothers. The M2 comes with Michelin Pilot Super Sport size 245/35R, 19 in front and 265/35R, 19 at the rear. The brakes are direct carryovers from the M4, though, and that means 4 piston calipers in front and 2 piston units in the rear, clamping iron rotors pinned to aluminum hats. Pedal bite is excellent and the brakes never feel taxed by the M2S speed.